Today, we explore the updates to Dynamics 365 from a B2B and B2C perspective with new capabilities such as relationship insights for sales optimization and talent discovery and hiring through LinkedIn integration, as well as the latest in intelligent and unified digital and in-store experiences for consumers and retail. And stay tuned as we'll show you how to light up these capabilities if you're an IT pro. Ryan Martin from the Dynamics 365 team. Welcome.
Good to be on the show, Jeremy.
There's been a lot of news on the Dynamics front with integration across LinkedIn, Office 365, and new options to support retail. But let's start with LinkedIn integration. What are we doing to support the sales scenarios there?
Yeah, we're leveraging LinkedIn to bring in relationship insights within the sales and hiring processes. With the latest release of Dynamics 365 for sales, you now have system of engagement that give you a 360-degree view of your prospects and pipeline, as you can see here on my dashboard. Let me walk you through an example. So I can see I have a 500K gap, and as we go into the details of that 500K gap, we actually see the opportunities that make up my pipeline. Typically, we used to see the estimated closing date and the value, but here we bring intelligence in where we can see the relationship health, whether it's good, whether it's poor, or whether it's fair. To make up my 500K gap, I'm actually looking at a pipeline that's closing in a couple days with the NBA. So as we move forward, I actually drill into the details of the particular opportunity, and we could see the business process associated with it. Here we see that the relationship assistant provides us an email reminder that we've had no response to an email that we've sent to Justin. And I can really improve the quality of the engagement by actually reaching out through the LinkedIn member profile, use my social network to reach out to Justin and send information.
So all this is using really cognitive services in the background to be able to measure the relationship health. But in the past, I might have had to do something like reach out to other colleagues, maybe people that know Justin, and kind of find other means to be able to engage with them, right?
Absolutely. That's what you might have tried before, but now, leveraging Sales Navigator directly within Dynamics 365, I see several people in my network who are connected to Justin. So we can have icebreakers, but we can also look at the get introduced, where we have, in this case, the people I'm directly connected to who know Justin, or someone we may be working with, in this case, Steven, who via Tim Link, I can actually use to ask for an introduction to Justin.
Okay, so now we're gonna use Steven then to contact Justin.
Yeah, Jeremy, what we're actually gonna do is we're gonna ask for the introduction through Steven. So as we move that forward in the process, what I'm actually going to do is use Sales Navigator, which is integrated with Dynamics 365, to type a personalized message to Steven in this particular case to ask him to share the content that I have prepared. Okay. Now this content exists on Point Drive. And Point Drive allows us to share files, documents, videos, making it easy for Steven to share the proposal that we created for the MBA. And he might also share that beyond with other influential contacts he has. So I'll actually go in and get the link for this particular Point Drive location, and I will include it into the messaging I'm sending Steven, and he will be able to actually send that on. But I want to make sure this information is in Dynamics 365, so we copy that message and we select send, and it is going to be stored throughout the system.
But now you're sharing a link through Steven to Justin, so how do I track who's actually engaged with that data or that content?
So that's a very good point. Within Point Drive, what we actually have is an overview of stats. And those stats actually allow us to view all of the assets that we've been sharing, mm-hmm. and it can take it a step further, not only show the assets that we have, but it'll also show the views that we have on those assets and the specific people who have been viewing the documents or the videos that we've been sharing.
So a really powerful set of tools, and that's all from the browser, but can I do some of this on my phone?
Absolutely. So what we see here is that I actually just received an email from Justin following the reviewing of the information that we see. And he's thanking me for the presentation that we've seen. Within the context of my Outlook on my iOS device here, I can actually pull in all of the Dynamics 365 data regarding the opportunity I've been working on. I can see the estimated closing date, the estimated revenue, and also specifics to Justin in terms of Dynamics data that we have.
So really powerful integration, and we can really see how this is going to progress your deal pipeline. How are we leveraging LinkedIn there to actually make the hiring process better?
Absolutely. We've just released Dynamics 365 for Talent to help streamline the hiring processes. Typically, as a hiring manager, it may be hard to get visibility into the full pipeline of candidates and the status of candidates who are really engaging with us. Now, with Dynamics 365 for Talent and the integrated application tracking systems, LinkedIn provides complete transparency between me and the recruiter. So actually, let's take a look. Here I am, the recruiter, and we have a position open for an accountant. As you can see, we have several people that have applied, they're in the screening process, and so forth. As we actually drill into the specifics of Cameron, who's in the interviewing process, we have the insights of setting up an appointment. And we're gonna take a look at that in a second. But for now, we'd actually look at the information he provided us as he applied to it. And it's where the power of LinkedIn comes into play. What we see is we have Cameron's LinkedIn profile embedded in Dynamics 365. We can see our connection path, our summary of his work experiences, and also the education experiences that he took at the University of Washington, for example. Going beyond seeing all that information from LinkedIn, we also can take a look at the resume that's been provided. And this resume integrates Dynamics 365 with Word Online. In this case, we see here Cameron's resume. We actually see the work skills he has, and he seems like a very experienced candidate, hence he's moved past the screening stage and has gone into the interview process.
It's really great seeing the integration here between Dynamics and Office 365 and Word Online, but now that we've got them into the interview process, are there things that we can do to support the interview process with this tool?
One of the areas of tremendous benefit is the streamlined scheduling process. Because of the integration between Dynamics 365, Office 365, we can actually confirm the team that are going to interview this candidate. We can set the date, we can set the time zone and the location. And what we're actually able to also do is define what type of interview is this going to take place. Today, we're actually going to see that it's an individual type of interview, but it's also possible that we would set up and have a panel interview in this case. Yeah. And of course, using Skype for Business, we can include this as an online meeting. So let's actually go in and see the suggestions. And as we select this option, what we will see is that we bring in the power of Office 365 in terms of the calendar. So we're actually going to look at the four interviewees that are going to actually apply this interview, and we're going to see when we suggest them to be available, and we're going to invite that team to actually take place for these interviews. We've received the responses from the candidates who are going to interview, and we will see that three of them have actually accepted this particular interview, but one has rejected. And now typically we could either propose a new time slot that we would see of an available opening, or we could decide that this is actually going to be an online meeting. So what we're gonna do here is confirm and send these invites. And as we do that, we can set obviously the location in which those meetings are gonna take place, but we're gonna provide also a personalized message. In the case of that one rejected appointment, we've decided that it is going to be taking place online due to the travel requirements that are necessary, hence they're not on location. So after we've typed the personalized message, we're actually going to be able to send that to the interviewers who are going to take a look at the candidate. Now, moving on further through the hiring process, as a manager and interviewer, after each interview, I want to provide the feedback on whether this is a hiring recommendation or not. Okay. With Talent, interviewers can easily enter their notes on the go from any device and say whether they think it's a strength, it's a weakness, and the particular information that they would like to provide back. So here we see me actually adding the particular strengths that I have from the interview in this case. But what I'm also able to do is go in and say, yes, I recommend that we hire Cameron, and so I'm going to submit that within the tool. But I'm interested, because I have those privileges, to see what the other team has provided in terms of feedback. So I may want to see, for example, what Brandon has provided in feedback. I can see what notes and strengths they have provided through each individual interviewer within the process.
So it looks like Cameron's hired now, or becoming hired. In support of that process, can we also do some things to tailor the onboarding experience once Cameron comes on?
Yes, we can use templates and create personalized onboarding experiences for Cameron as he comes on. So what we're seeing here is actually an introduction mail being created for Cameron as he starts to the onboard process for the required trainings and activities are gonna take place. So this is from me using the specific template, but as we would also be able to move forward, we could get the view of how that looks for when Cameron starts to. So we enter a preview stage to make sure everything is correct for our candidates so they have the best onboarding experience as possible. So what we see here is as Cameron onboards, he has a series of activities that he has to take to get to know trainings that might be necessary, and we can provide a lot of information and make this onboarding experience seamless.
The cool thing here, though, is because we're using Flow and there are a lot of IT folks watching, you can do a lot of stuff then in the back end to do other things like maybe provision Office 365 services, order them hardware, business cards, maybe even get a company car ordered up through the Power Flow.
Yeah, absolutely. You can extend this experience further, and you can actually have the ability to embed Power Apps within the Dynamics 365 processes we've seen today.
So I know the team's also invested a lot in terms of bringing the retail experience up to date, more intelligent, with experiences that really span that business to consumer perspective.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've integrated some of the most recent tech and new experiences to deliver intelligent and efficient retail sales experiences. So we've actually been working with Michael Hill to build out their app and in-store experience. And here I am in their app looking for some jewelry for my wife, Danica. I've added a few things to my favorites for this moment. And when I actually access those things, I can do things like choose the color of the watch that we're looking for. And again, update my favorites here, in which we'll see that that was a success and I get the message. Now, as I leave this and several days later, I enter the in-store experience, what you'll see is as I go to the in-store experience, I actually receive a notification that they have a special deal for me. And as I select that notification, because I'm in-store, we actually see that there's 20% off today.
Now, this is where it gets really cool, because if you move to my PC, I'm an actual sales associate this time, and I'm playing the part of Larissa. Now, Larissa's seen you come to the store with this device. Because the beacon can see that you've entered the store, I can actually see exactly what you're interested in, the previous purchase history that you've got, the things on your wish list, recommended products, and I can make it really easy in terms of the purchase process and show you what you want. Maybe you have more time than to shop for further stuff or just be on your way very quickly and effortlessly in that retail experience.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it's very cool seeing the modern app experience and beacon technology feeding the in-store system, but there are a lot of IT folks probably watching today wondering, what does it take to get everything up and running?
Yeah, for the LinkedIn integrated sales experience, you'll want to check out AppSource. Now, AppSource is the one-stop shop for all of our cloud solutions, Dynamics 365, Power BI, and Office 365. And within AppSource, if I search for LinkedIn, what you'll see is we'll have a series of results, and the app that we've been looking at today is LinkedIn Sales Navigator from Microsoft Dynamics. Now, it's as easy as contacting this solution, getting the solution, and importing it into Dynamics 365 to light it up. The small note we'd like to make is we combine Dynamics 365 user licenses with Sales Navigator licenses.
So you also showed us relationship insights where we're able to see things like the health of the relationship with Justin. How do I enable that?
Yeah, the relationship insights preview is not enabled by default. You need to enable each feature before you're able to use that. And we'll do that in Dynamics 365. In the settings module, I'll actually go here to relationship insights. And what we'll see is that we have the relationship assistant, the auto capture, and email engagement. Now, in particular today, what we saw was email engagement cards that have been turned on that show me when an email has been opened or that provide me an email reminder if someone has not viewed my actual information.
Now, you showed us Dynamics 365 for talent. How is that enabled?
Using the lifecycle services for Dynamics 365, you can start a project, and this will guide you through the process of deployment. Mm-hmm. This leverages the common data platform for Dynamics 365 with built-in extension points for Microsoft Flow, Power BI, and Power Apps. And by the way, this is the same process for retail, taking into consideration additional things like beacon technology and the mobile app. For more information, please check out the links below.
So lots of powerful integration between Dynamics 365 and LinkedIn and Office 365. It's really cool to see all the new intelligent retail experiences light up, but what's next?
We have a 6-month release cycle, and you can keep up to date by visiting our Dynamics 365 public roadmap. This provides a snapshot of what we're working on.
So can I try out these new capabilities right now?
Yes, you can try out all these capabilities via the links below.
So thanks, Ryan, for joining us today, and thank you for joining us on Microsoft Mechanics. Of course, keep checking back for the latest updates across Microsoft. We'll see you next time.